Okay, here we go.
What is this?
Destroy the gate! Anabalon is here!
Malphael is my brother. I fought 1,000 battles by his side, and I care not that he seeks to destroy you and your kind. But my brother has grown sick, and he must be put down for his own sake. Yet I have not the heart to do this. And so it falls to you. Come, Nephilim, to Pandemonium.
He can delay the inevitable, but he underestimates my persistence. I will cross the ancient battleground of the angels and demons, and journey on to the gates of the Pandemonium Fortress. This angel has disrupted the balance between life and death, and it falls to me to rebuke him.
Why would Imperius want you to follow him? I don't like this.
Oh, this is trippy looking. I like the look of this place.
There is a siege camp not far from here. Meet me there, and I will show you what must be done.
Can't stand around in this place. Forgot about that. Read that again. Whoa!
You will need to do better if you want to stand any chance.
Yeah? Where would you be without me? Right?
My bag is full.
Holy crap. Okay, we're gonna do this quick.
This is what the extra inventory
space is for. I'll deal with this stuff later.
See the battering ram below.
Yeah,
that is the only way you can breach the fortress gates.
Yeah.
But it is useless without the siege runes that power it. You have one in your possession, but there are two more. You will find them on the battlefield below, imprisoned along with the demons that carried them. Once you have the runes, go to the ram. But know this, Nephilim. Even if you release Malfael from his madness, I will not thank you for it.
Indeed.
You know, I just thought of something. Why can't we build a ladder? And just crawl over the wall. Never mind. On the hard drive. Done yet. Okay. Come on. Stupid. Whoa. Oh, my wrist. What to do? Okay. Loop.
This world can abide you no longer. We have done it.
So, this is where the eternal conflict raged since the beginning of time. When I fight a battle, I mean to win it. Eternal? Sounds rather pointless, doesn't it?
The only one's worth fighting.
Now inhabits the fortress. I am certain of it. Long have I gazed upon its scarred facade, dreaming of the safe haven its walls offer. But it has changed. The vacant terraces have turned cold. I am so desperate to escape the demons. Whatever is in the fortress may be mine. The Alpha and the Omega of the Eternal Conflict. It lies at the center of all things, linking the realms of...
This is the way to the Ram. I'd best find the siege runes first.
Thank you.
Nephilim! We found something we can use!
Yeah?
Long ago, this weapon was used to bring down a mighty siege beast and its demon master. Even now, the device maintains its power. Sadly, the weapon now attacks us as well as our enemies. We can use it in this fight, though, if we can regain control of it. Nephilim, to me! I will protect you!
I don't know what I'm doing.
To us now. At least it cannot do any more damage.
The great weapon was created in response to a siege on the Pandemonium Fortress by Kurikos, a demon lord who rode a monstrous siege beast. At great cost to ourselves, we channeled much energy into the great weapon and succeeded in bringing down Kurikos and his mount. Upon his death, the demon was drawn inexplicably into the weapon, and it has been attacking us ever since.
Well, can't have that anymore.
This place is like the nightmare of some madman. Down.
stop being melty and I'll walk over that. Thank you.
To lead an army of the blind, they do not perceive that the angels are fleeing this realm, and the ones they find are merely trapped or lost. A great change is upon us. Withdraw from the fields, my brothers. Some battles can only be won with words.
Pandemonium was destined to be our battlefield. It was formed in the chaos of the last struggle between the Diamond Warrior Anu and the Dragon Tathanet. Now, eons of war have scarred every patch of ground. The cycle of victory and defeat is the foundation of our existence.
My essence is to know.
It roams the outskirts of Pandemonium, a lumbering giant with a gaping hollow at its core. Somehow, it can hide its body away, disguising itself as a mere portal. Those who pass through it are trapped in a distant world, never to be seen again.
Kill this one.
It's gonna bite you no longer.
Now we go in. This is different.
Cycles.
Oh, get up the thing.
I like to think the world is safer now.
Corpse.
brutes to shreds.
My master would take pride in this. Turning to town.
Whee!
Thank you.
That was invigorating.
Pandemonium. The aspect of justice called for a fortress to be raised around the Worldstone. We built a shining citadel, but in time it fell quickly. It has since changed hands countless times, becoming a patchwork of angelic and demonic expression.
There, a worthy foe! This world can abide you no longer!
I bear grave news, my friend. The Sliver has revealed Malphail's plan to me, and it is worse than I could have imagined. He means to use the Black Soul Stone to capture all demonic essences, even those that linger in human hearts. If the stone is altered to rip the demonic essence out of every man, woman, and child on Sanctuary, they will all die.
Quickly, then. We must begin the attack.
Malphail is fundamentally altering the Black Soul Stone. It will now pull in all the demonic essence from whatever plane of existence it finds itself in. But mankind is born of angel and demon alike. Every mortal, save myself, has demonic essence as an intrinsic part of their being. Losing that will rip their body and soul apart.
Here and then start back up again and then